Hey there, my name is Bhagesh and today I'm gonna show you how to install Java on Docker. So today's our agenda is to create a Java environment on Docker without installing Java on our operating system. So we will run this program on Docker. So let's write our Docker Compose file. So version will be 3.7. Then we'll create services section. So our service will be Java environment. Image name will be OpenJDK and version will be 19-slim. And if you are using Linux, then use version 16-alpine 3.13. Now next is container name. We'll say Java env. So next is our working directory. So what we'll do, we'll write our code in one directory and we'll bind that directory to the one Docker directory and we'll name it as a programs. So our local directory, we will bind it now. So inside volumes $home/user/programs, inside that Java, this will be bind to the programs. So we have told image name to the Docker and which directory we will be putting our code into. So when we will be creating the container, there will be no process running. So we want one process that should keep running in the background to keep container active. So we'll pass one command, tail -f /dev/null. So our tail command will keep looking for dev/null and that will keep our container alive. Now let's create a container using docker compose up command. So yes, it says container Java environment is started. Now let's get into the container shell. To get into the shell, command is docker execute -it Java env sh. Yes, let's print pwd. So we are in the programs directory and that is our working directory. Now in our directory we have code example.java. So to run the Java program, command is java and the file name. So yes, you can see Java running on Docker. If I change message Java running on Docker, as you can see, changes are getting reflected. Now inside the Docker Compose file, if you are running some server code, you can expose port and also bind the ports. If you have some small project, you can also specify the environment file here. Alright guys, that's all about this tutorial. I hope you have learned something new today. Thank you.